Hey guys, I'm Steve Harrison, Liberty Lodge 31, Liberty, Missouri, for the Masonic Curators. I'm standing in the Masonic Library in Columbia, Missouri, which was dedicated a few years ago by none other than Clifton Truman Daniel, Harry Truman's grandson. I'd like you to see this film that I'm about to show, which explains things about this library much better than I ever could.
The Missouri Lodge of Research and Missouri Masonic Research Library was a dream of Missouri Masonic leaders since the 1920s, when John Picard, Ravy Denslow, Henry Childs, and others formed the Missouri Masonic Research Council. These far-thinking Masons saw the need to assist the craft in understanding the complexities of Masonry, understanding the meaning of the ritual, and providing a basis to help good men become better. Existing from 1920 to 1940, the Missouri Masonic Research Council evolved into a chartered lodge whose charter was signed by Grand Master Harry S. Truman, then United States Senator from the state of Missouri. As early as 1951, the Lodge of Research established a library in Jackson County Public Library, Independence, Missouri, with over 500 volumes in its collection. At the same time, under the direction of Ravy Denslow, the Lodge of Research started publishing its transactions, telling the story of Masonry in Missouri and elsewhere around the world. Most of these books were written by Ravy Denslow and afterwards by his son, William R. Denslow, both past Grand Masters of the Grand Lodge of Research and past Masters and Fellows of the Missouri Lodge of Research. Eventually, the Lodge of Research collection was transferred to the newly completed Harry S. Truman Presidential Library. It was the desire of President Truman to have the Lodge of Research Library as part of his presidential library, but due to constraints arising from the interaction with the government, the collection was boxed up and returned to the Grand Lodge of Missouri. These books and other historic material remained in those boxes until 2012. In 2012, the advancing line of the Grand Lodge, in conjunction with the Masonic Home of Missouri, established the first permanent home for the Lodge of Research Library, naming the same the Missouri Masonic Research Library. The library is a research library and is not a lending library at the present time. Since 2012, over 12,000 books and related Masonic historical material has been cataloged in the library collection. As the boxes of books were opened and prepared to be cataloged, some rare and important books were found. Imagine opening a box and finding the handwritten minutes of Missouri's only military lodge, Lodge Number 86, who was chartered into Independence immediately following those that had embarked on the Santa Fe Trail and met New Mexico for the duration of the Mexican-American War, or finding a copy of Jean Sirius's signed Masonic sheet music with a cover letter on the White House stationery sending the music to the boys, or the Lodge of Research simply signed by Harry, or several copies of the new trestle board, the report of the 1846 Baltimore Convention, co-chaired by past Grand Master Carnegie of Missouri. Our research library was founded to preserve the past for the benefit of the present and the enlightenment of the future. Ravy Denslow was one of the most prolific Masonic authors ever to live in Missouri. Thanks to Trenton Lodge No. 111, the library now hosts the Denslow Collection. These books deal with the history of the Grand Lodge, the Missouri York Rite bodies, and other Masonic bodies. One of the great finds is a 1,000-page, hand-typed, personal memoir written by Brother Denslow. The Lodge of Research will be publishing this information through a series of three books in 2019, 2020, and 2021. Jim Williams, past Grand High Priest of the Royal Arch of Missouri, also had an extensive collection of Masonic books. Thanks to the Valley of St. Joseph Scottish Rite, these books have been added to the collection in the library for the enlightenment of the future. This year, Don Huggins, past District Deputy Grand Master of the 22nd Masonic District of Missouri, donated his 1,000-book collection of Masonic and Masonic-related books to the library. The Missouri Masonic Research Library operates complexly with volunteer help. The library does not have any paid staff. Work days have been established as the third Saturday of every month from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. There is always a need for volunteers on scheduled work days. Another area of assistance needed is a team of docents. These volunteers would volunteer a half a day a week to man the library while the Masonic complex is open. In turn, this would require 10 volunteers to fill the schedule. The docents can be men, women, Masons, Eastern Star members, or anyone interested in making the library available would be appreciated. The work that is being completed today is for the benefit of the future. As the history of Masonry is cataloged and placed in the library for Masonic study, future generations will find it much easier to find their answers to their Masonic inquiries. The library will also be a repository of the archives of Masonry in Missouri. Closed but not forgotten lodges, chapters, councils, and commandery will find the library a safe home for their historical records. Come visit the library. Take some time to study the past in Masonry and elsewhere in the world, and enjoy the great history the library can provide.